This third video provides a basic explanation of probability density functions, often abbreviated to PDFs. This applies in general, but is focused on the difference between classical and quantum mechanics. In the classical mechanics, many motions are sinusoidal, like with a mass spring system and a pendulum. The PDF is then determined by the relative length of a sinus function. Physically, one could say that the PDF is determined by the sinusoidal change in velocity and the standstill of a body. In the quantum mechanics, the velocity of a particle in the infinite whirl is constant. The PDF is then determined by the relative length of the helix spiral trajectory. Differential equations and statistics form no longer part of the Dutch high school standard math program. Therefore, I will provide a very brief introduction of PDFs. A probability relates directly to the outcome of an occurrence, like with throwing a dice or a cone. A PDF does not provide directly a probability of a particular event. It only describes the distribution of all possible outcomes. The probability of a specific outcome between two boundaries is then calculated as the area underneath the PDF above the x-axis and between these two boundaries. There exist many PDFs with all a different shape. The sheet shows only four of them. A PDF is normalized, which means that the total area is made equal to 1. They are described with their mean values and the standard deviation. The latter is often called sigma. With a uniform distribution, the PDF is constant. The normalized normal distribution is also called a Gaussian or a bell-shaped PDF. In the mechanical theory, the PDF for sinusoidal motions is often referred to as the classical PDF. These describe the position, velocity and acceleration as sinusoidal functions. Mathematically, this describes the relative length of a sinus function. In the amplitudes, this PDF goes to infinity. In the quantum mechanics, the square of the wave is interpreted as the PDF for the actual position of the particle. This PDF is also interpreted as where the particle is and it best can be observed. This assumption is purely based on observations, but factually there is no theoretical basis for this interpretation. In my previous videos, I've explained that this PDF relates to the helix spiral motion of the particle. A harmonic mass spring system describes a sinusoidal motion in time. Also, its velocity and accelerations are sinusoidal. Its velocity is maximum in the middle and zero in extreme positions. Therefore, it will be relatively shortly in the middle and relatively long near the standstill positions. With small angles and displacements, a pendulum has the same PDF as the mass spring system. In the standstills, the PDF goes to infinity. In the vertical position, the PDF is equal to 1 divided by pi. With a vibrating string, each mass element has its own classical PDF. The width of this PDF is equal to 2 times the amplitude of that element. With higher frequencies, the energy in a string remains constant and the amplitude reduces with 1 divided by n. The question is then why higher harmonics do actually occur. My own explanation is that this is required to reduce the actual energy flows within the string between the uniformly distributed spring energy and the sinus square distribution of the kinetic energy. Also hereby distributions are used. In the animation, the pool ball bounces perpendicular up and down between the two boundaries. It assumes that its velocity and energy are constant and that it moves in a straight line between the two boundaries. This results in a PDF with a uniform distribution for the position of the pool ball between its two boundaries. My helix spiral model is developed to provide a logical and plausible interpretation for both the Schrödinger wave functions and the square of the wave functions. It meets the requirement that in each quantum state the velocity, momentum and energy are constant. The envelope of the helix spiral trajectory is sinusoidal in accordance with the Schrödinger wave function in an infinite whirl. The frequency distribution within the trajectory is determined such that the relative length of the trajectory is in compliance with the sinus squared PDF. Since the velocity is constant, this PDF then also applies to the actual position of the particle within the well. P Please note that the PDF is not dependent upon the number of windings within the helix spiral trajectory. Next to each other, the difference in PDF and the forces involved become very clear. In summary, one could say that the classical PDF is determined by the change in velocity. In the quantum mechanics, the PDF is determined by the relative length of the helix spiral trajectory. The motion of a particle in a box involves a completely different physical process than that with a mass in the classical mechanics. Therefore, the behavior of a particle in a box cannot be explained on the basis of classical vibrations. However, it can be explained on the broader knowledge in the classical mechanics. A theory, does it make it also science? Within the quantum mechanics, the interpretation of the Schrödinger wave function is still unclear. There is also no theoretical basis for the usual interpretation of the squared wave functions. In my elaborate analysis, I have clearly demonstrated that the wave functions and the square of the wave functions cannot be explained on the basis of the classical vibrations of a particle. This has finally resulted in the development of my helix spiral model. If it is also scientifically correct, I honestly don't know. However, it meets all the boundary conditions and accepted assumptions within the quantum mechanics. It certainly provides a very clear, logical and plausible explanation that is easy to understand. And that was my personal goal. Hopefully this video has made the interpretation of PDF somewhat clearer. And also the differences between the classical and quantum mechanics. Please visit my website for a more detailed explanation.